regard this meeting. Today's concept is, first, we should know data-driven testing. Data-driven testing means already tested functionality again and again. If you test with multiple sets of data, so that is called data-driven testing. If it is manual testing, we will call retesting. If it is automation testing, we will call data-driven testing. Data-driven testing means already tested functionality again and again. We will test with multiple sets of data. So not only single set of data, we will take with multiple sets of data and we will do testing. So that's why that is called data-driven testing. That is all data-driven testing. With annotations, we will implement here. So that's the reason we can say it is a data-driven framework. So what is data-driven framework? We will discuss today. Very, very important concept to data-driven testing. So go to Google. So Wikipedia. I'm going to Wikipedia site. First, I'm going to top of the page search. I'm entering India. First, I'm entering India. So we will get one India title. So I want to get the title. Next, I want to give another country name, Canada. I want to get that country name Canada. Okay. Next, I want to give Brazil. I want to get the Brazil. Okay. So, data-driven testing means implement retesting. Retesting means already tested functionality. Here, search functionality already tested. But I am giving different sets of data, not only single set of data. We are giving different sets of data and we are getting the site names. So that is called data driven testing. So if you implement with the annotation, so that is called data driven testing. So today's concept is data driven testing. So only we will take a Wikipedia site and we will enter some countries names and we will get the title. So what are the titles? We can get in console. Okay. Data driven testing. So I will write the program in my Eclipse. After that, I will copy paste in your system. So it will execute. Right. Go to Luna. Very simple. Go to SRC, it is the new class data. Take the class data driven frame. So annotations we are using, just direct click on finish. You are observe carefully. I'm writing one public web driver, public web driver WD. So this is a global declaration. And to take one URL, public string URL. I'm taking two things. Web driver, what you open to Selenium, right? So here I'm taking annotation, data provider annotation. This is the test engine annotation, data provider. Name equal. My test. Name equal to my test. Public. And declaring one object array. Object. It is a multi-dimensional array. So give two brackets. Create data. data 1 or anything you can give it. Return function also I am writing here only. Return new object. Who should be cap? I know. So here is no need of colon. Data provider test engine annotation. Right, I am declaring object array India. Comma. Canada. Come. India, Canada. If you want give another country, you can give it. So it will take time waste process. UK. Come. Closing bracket, right. Once again, we need to close another one. 1, 2, 3. So, right. After that, we can write it. At the rate, I am taking before method. So, public void site. Site name we should give. Which site, if you want work with site name, we should write here. First we need to invoke the Firefox server. WD equal to new Firefox server. So now I am using URL. URL equal to, I am giving the site name. Site name is just now we this close it up. Wikipedia.org site name. Right. This is the site name. Copy. Keep in double colon. Control. Right. Enough. This is the before method. Before method. Firefox driver. Oh, I'm going to site. Site name is over. Next, I'm taking one annotation. At the red test. So in the address test I am writing data provider. So I give data provider equal to, I give name is my test. My test. I give name is my test. Given double colons. We can get the data from this my test. You can get the data from my test. Now, public, void, test, search country, search, country, search country. So country name is string. So write string. String country, country, string country, string country. Right. We need go to Wikipedia site. So www.get. Here we should. Here is one very very important. URL place. I want to work with Wikipedia. URL place double colon wiki dot main underscore page. So it will go to Wikipedia main page. It will go to main page. It will go to main page. Okay. Next, I want to clear the field first of all. WD dot find element by dot XPath. I'm giving XPath or ID. I'm giving ID. So ID, I know that ID is, I think, search input. Okay, if it is wrong, once again we can check it. Search input. I know that ID. That's the reason directly I'm writing. Dot clear. Right. Copy. Control V. Next, we need to enter the country name. Send keys. Country. I gave name is country. 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 And click. Dot click. Enough. Code is over. Country. Why it is showing error? Find element by ID. Set input. Send keys. Country. What's wrong? Oh, double. Next, after method. Close bracket, at the rate after method. After method, public void, close. WD.it. Enough. This is the code. Very simple. Here is very not simple code after method.
Sir, here you said send keys country, kada search input.
Ah, yes.
Line 34 or 35.
Data provider. Wait. Data provider. Data provider. Okay. Any error now? Still. No, asking doubt.
Okay. So you created this create data method with values India, Canada and UK.
Yes.
Okay. Now if you see, go back to down line 35, you're saying you are searching for the input box and you're sending keys country.
Country.
But you don't have, but where is country here?
Yes,
country
I gave here. Test search country, public word set, test to search country, I gave string country. So it can get the data from country. So why? Because here I gave my test. Okay, I'm taking in my test. It can get the data from my test. Okay, this program is not running in my computer, but it will run in your computer. Save. Click on run. So it
So
will
but
not
if I, so it takes the values
from my test,
from my test, which is India, Canada, and all, and it will come.
it will execute. So just tell me what email ID fast.
Okay, but I doubt it because I have Firefox, you said, right? Because Firefox again is a new version.
It is working or not?
No, Firefox new version is not working, sir, with the, but maybe we can try.
Okay. Yesterday test engine worked in your computer, I think.
Yeah, test engine worked in my computer, but I'm saying
Okay.
you gave
Now
Firefox
just
trying,
once
right?
you tell me what email ID, I can just I will copy paste and once I need to run. So if it is working, okay.
Yeah.
Otherwise, this is the concept. So very simple concept. So I'm taking at the data provider. It is a test ng annotation. So there is no JUnit annotation
No.
for data provider. That's the reason. So if it is test ng annotation, compulsory we should use this one, test ng only.
Okay. Yeah, my ID is 132.
One, three, two, I know. Password.
09087692749274.
Nine, two, seven, four. Oh God, I'm getting number of windows. All right, where is Eclipse?
Nothing's coming up.
No repair programs. No repair.
Can we do it with the TestNG demo project? Can we do it in that? Yeah.
Take the new class data. You can't finish. Control V. No web driver programs in your computer.
Let's import them then. Can we go back there?
Just do it fast.
Okay. So ee pain ravalante to go back to that one.
That's the reason I ask, madam, where exactly I need to paste.
Kaadu, what I mean is if we go where do we go back to the project pane and how do we go back to the project pane and
So just go to it.
I mean it was working here in this one, that's why I wanted to take it. Yeah.
No. Right click on project. Go to properties. Do it, do it. Testing demo. Delete one bracket by add by. Right. Save. Click on run. It will go to Wikipedia site. Wait, wait. Wait.
Shall I just give Chrome path?
What?
Should I give instead of Firefox driver, shall we do Chrome? I can paste the
Yes,
Chrome
do it,
thing.
do it. Just copy and paste Chrome ID. No. No Chrome.
ఉంది క్రోమ్ ఉంది కానీ ఎక్కడ రాసానో నేను చూసిన జస్ట్ కాపీ
సెకండ్ లైన్ ఆల్సో ఓకే ఓకే నో ప్రాబ్లం థర్డ్ వన్
అదే వచ్చింది అవసరం లేదండి
ఇట్ విల్ రన్ స్లోలీ వెయిట్ ఎస్ ఇట్ విల్ ఎంటర్ నెక్స్ట్ ఇట్ విల్ ఎంటర్ త్రీ టైమ్స్ ఇండియా కెనడా బ్రెజిల్ యూకే 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 సో త్రీ టెస్ట్ రన్ ఫెయిల్యూర్ జీరో స్కిప్ జీరో క్విట్ ఐ రోట్ క్విట్ త్రీ టైమ్స్ ఇట్ విల్ బి లాగిన్ త్రీ టైమ్స్ ఇట్ విల్ బి లాగ్ అవుట్ That is the concept of
It didn't work
data
because
driven.
it was a Firefox thing.
Next concept.
I'll take this one out. Wait 1 second.
Copy. In the notes also I need to update.
Sir, okay, I'll ask you later.
This is a big code, but it will be small now. Right. Say. Next concept of page object model framework. Next concept name is page object model framework. Page object model framework. Very, very important. Already disconnected my connection. No. That's the reason. My voice double I am getting. Page object model framework. What is page object model framework? Page object model framework is a design pattern to create object repository for all web UI elements. So each and every page. So for example, I'm taking one page, username, password, sign in button. So these are the web elements. So that is the web page. Only for page, we will create one object repository and we will maintain corresponding page class. That's concept is called page object model framework. We will create one repository for one particular page. So in the page, we have three elements. For example, we have three elements. Only for three element purpose, we will create one object repository class. And corresponding, we will maintain another class. So that's the reason that is the page object model framework. This is a very, very important framework. Nowadays, all the companies, they are using this framework. That is the page object model framework. Here, I wrote it. Page object model framework has nowadays become very popular test automation framework in the industry. And many companies are using it because of its easy test maintenance and reduce the duplication of code. The main advantage of page object model is that if the UI changes for any page, if you don't require to change any tests, we just need to change only the code within the page objects only one place only. Many other tools which are using Selenium page object model. So this is very, very important concept. That is a page object model concept, page object model framework. In my system, test engine is not working, then we can use JUnit also. Okay, only if you want to implement data provider, that time we need test engine. If it is normal other framework, no need of anything. So just you can take JUnit, you can take test engine. Okay, right. Today concept to POM, page object model framework. POM, take the new class. Class name is POM, page object model framework. POM. So first I am taking one class name is login. Only login function, login class name I am taking login. Okay, so which site I want to take now? So I am going to Orange HRM. Go to Google Orange HRM. So here in this page we have three elements only. I am concentrating on only three elements. I want to give username and I want to give password. I want to click on login button. This is my intention and concentration. Just I want to click on three web elements only. I want to enter username. I want to enter password. I want to click on login button. Only I want to click on username. I want to click on password. I want to enter password. I want to click on login button. This is my intention. Only for this page three element purpose I will create one repository. How we can create the repository, today we will discuss. Before going to this concept, first of all we should know constructor. So not discussed about constructor, right?
Yeah, we didn't discuss about it.
Yes, actually this is the first concept only, madam. In the first class only I need to discuss. So but if I discuss in the first day only, so you will forget all those things. So you will feel like it is very difficult. So that's the reason we didn't discuss constructor. What is constructor? I will tell you. So middle of the concept I will tell you. First of all, I want to give username and password. I need to click on login button. This is my intention, concentration. So how to give the username? So first get all the web buttons IDs. All the IDs, get it now. First get it now, all the IDs. So first I need to create the object repository. How to create the object repository? Go to Eclipse. Here I am writing static web driver WD. Static web driver WD. Static web driver WD. So web driver is a predefined class, import the statements, right? By username, by username equal to by dot ID. I'm giving the ID. So I know that ID, but I know ID. So what is that ID? Just get it. ID is test username. Copy. Come here. Control V. Control V. By username, by password. I'm giving the password, text password. So we need to give the username and password, sign in button, login button. Text password, copy. Control V. Login button, BTN button. Copy. BTN login, control. Username, password. I'm writing login. Right. By is a keyword. By. So now I'm writing one constructor. How we can write constructor? Today first concept, how to write the constructor. Public void public class name login. Public class name login. Web driver WD. This WD equal to WD. This is the constructor. So before going to constructor concept, what is constructor? Constructor. What is constructor? First concept, constructor. First opening concept to constructor. First of all, we need to discuss constructor concept, then only we need to discuss all these concepts. So, but if I teach in the first class only, you can feel very difficult. That's the reason I didn't teach you constructor. What is constructor? Constructor is something. Constructor is something which is used for, which is used for constructing an object, constructing an object very easily. So syntax. 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 Modifier. Class name. Modifier, class name, data type, argument 1, comma, data type, argument 2. Like we can write it. So already we discussed static properties and non-static properties. All the bias having some common properties that is called static properties. All the bias not having some common property that is non-static properties. So non-static properties we discussed name, color, class of study and interested game. For example, so class, color and name, color, interested game and class of study. These are the non-static properties. For example, so how we can write? At a time we want to write in only single line. Modifier means public. Okay. Or public or private or default or protected. We can write class name. So class name here is login. Class name login. So we can write the constructor. Okay. How we can write data type? So name is string, argument 1 name, comma, string, color, comma, string, COS, class of study, no space. Class of study, string, INS game, INS game. Like we can write it. This is the constructor. So if you don't know constructor concept, each and every time we should write public login string name, public login string color, public login string class of study, public login string INS game we should write. But four properties we are writing in only single line, so that's the reason this is the constructor. Constructor is nothing but it is something which is used for constructing an object very easily. Okay.
So instead of creating four methods, four times different properties, we're just using one.
One. So that's the reason constructor is something which is used for constructing an object very easily. Simply we are constructing, right? What is n? What is name? What is color? We can write it. Or otherwise, simply we can write n. Simple we can write c. So what is c? What is color? We can write it later. Okay. Otherwise, directly we can write it. Okay. So this is the constructor concept. Here also I am writing modifier public, class name login, web driver. Web driver is a okay, one is the data type. Okay, data, for example, we are taking data type, so that is the argument one, no? So this WD equal to WD, only this line purpose. So constructor concept is required, constructor concept is required, otherwise no need of constructor. Okay, that's the reason I didn't teach you begin of the class. So here only we will use this constructor, so that's the reason. Okay, right now I'm writing public function, so I give properties. Now I am writing functions, public void x means username, x is a username. For example, I don't want to write username something big word, so wd dot find element username. I gave username, so username, so set the username. What is the username? Dot send keys admin, caps admin, admin, right? Enough. I gave function for username copy, control V, control V, admin Y. Password. Z. Dot click. This is the object repository. This is the object repository.
Find element login karta.
Jed. No. Username login. I give them login. Just you should remember this one. Okay. Whatever. Login. Okay. This is the object repository. This is the object repository. Save.
Why there's an error?
Why it is showing error? Just you need to check it. Why it is showing error? Why it is showing error? Open bracket, close bracket. Assignment must be available. The left hand side of an assignment is must be available. WD equal to WD. WD equal to WD. No. Login function I am taking WD. I think there is no bracket. Still it is showing error. Public login web driver WD, right to starting web driver WD, right to this WD equal to WD, right to what happened? Why it is showing wrong? Login already is there. No. WD equal to WD. This, no, sorry. This dot WD. This dot WD equal to WD. So very small issue, but sometimes it stop the program. Go to SRC, take the new class POM. Click on finish. Take one test, at the right test. At the right test. First write the function public void Indra. Nobody equal to. Here is no class, new class, FabDriver. FabDriver WD equal to new Firefox driver. WD dot get, give the site name. Copy. Control. So I want to call that functions. So which function I want to call? Login. L equal to new login. Why I need to create the object? Here is any required. Why? Because already I wrote non-static functions. I wrote non-static function. That's the reason I wrote login L equal to new login. Login L equal to new login. What happened? Why it is showing error? Right. Here we should write constructor WD. L dot X. L dot Y. L dot Z. Right. Testing annotation, not testing annotation. I am taking JUnit annotation. So JUnit is working in my system. So it will go to
We can do it in test ng also, only
but right now in my system JUnit is working. So same thing. Only if you want use only data provider, that time compulsory testing required. Username, password, enter into page. So that is the concept. So here is what is going on here. So only for each and every page I am creating object repository. That is the concept. Corresponding page class I am also maintaining, and corresponding page class also I am maintaining. So this is the
corresponding page class.
POM is a corresponding page class. So if it is any property change, then we will change here only. Just we will change here only. Remaining concept is same to same. So this is the reduce the time. There is no duplication. So there is no chance to duplication.
Okay.
This is the page object model framework concept. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay, thank you, madam. This is the today's session.
Okay.
Okay. Have a nice day. Take care.
Sir, we need dynamic binding, upcasing, downcasing.
Tomorrow class. But you need to do one thing. Just urgent on this part. Just you can keep the message to MindCube people. So course is completed. So why? Because so then only I can get the salary. So really.